apologies from my part. So I'll be presenting on correlation of quality of vision lens in, density and dysfunctional lens index in presbyopes. The authors have no financial interest in the subject matter of this presentation. So the diagnosis of cataract has evolved over the year from naked eye examination to torchlight to slit lamp and now high magnification.
The timer, please, please. Timer. Idhar nahi dikha de raha. Okay, can you just tell us the timer?
Tools, so even the tools to diagnose cataract have evolved from torchlight to slit lamp. For the longest time, we were using the LOX 3 classification and now the Pentacam and the iTrace. So often we experience 40 to 60 year old patients walking into our OPD and they have night driving and they always complain of halos, glare and starburst. Now when we examine these patients, most of these patients have best corrected visual acuity of 20 by 20 N6. When we examine their lens, most of these patients again have clear lenses, but still they say we face halos, glares and starbursts. So going through some review of literature, American Journal of Ophthalmology spoke about quality of life research and how traditional approaches to developing rating scales should be developed. Dysfunctional lens index is a term coined to describe the natural aging changes in the crystalline lens. Also, there is now growing acceptance of objectively categorizing the amount of cataract that is present. We have the iTrace, which now gives us separately what the internal aberrations are and what separately are the aberrations on the cornea. Now, these internal aberrations are what the dysfunctional lens syndrome is. Current modalities cannot quantify dysfunctional lens, but are aberrations enough? Introducing the dysfunctional lens index, which is an index of multifactorially that comes in the iTrace. Already there is already published literature on comparison of dysfunctional lens index as well as correlation of objective metrics for quantifying dysfunctional lens syndrome. So the research question is, can we obtain any parameter that can quantify the dysfunctional lens and can we correlate it with metrics of quality of vision? The aim is to describe dysfunctional lens index in presbyopes and its correlation with quality of vision and lens density changes based on LOCS3 and shine plug lens density. Inclusion criteria: age group 40 to 60, clear lens or early lens changes on slit lamp evaluation. And exclusion criteria: presence of corneal opacity, posterior subcapsular cataracts, obvious lenticular changes, and posterior segment pathologies. Ethics committee approval was taken and informed consent was taken from all the patients. Sample size was 158. The materials and methods: it was a prospective observational cross-sectional study. All patients underwent visual acuity and came out to be 20/20 N6. Then on slit lamp, according to LOCS3 grading, we graded the cataract, followed by PNS staging on the Pentacam, along with the DLI, the modular transfer function, and internal aberrations on the iTrace. Also, we gave them QOL questionnaires, that is quality of life questionnaires. So this is how on the Pentacam we see 0, 1, 2 as grading of the cataract. And similarly on the iTrace from a scale of 1 to 10, we get what the dysfunctional lens index is. So in this particular case, it is 5.78. So the results, the average age was 57.92, 75 males, 83 females, and a DLI of less than 5 was there in 17 patients, 5 to 7 in 45, and more than 7 in 96 patients. Slit lamp examination versus PNS grading. So here what we found was that out of the 76 patients that we found clear on our slit lamp examination, the Pentacam gave it as a grade 1 in 51 patients. And out of the 82 in which we found lens changes on the slit lamp, the Pentacam gave 18 as grade 0. Whereas on the DLI, that is the iTrace, out of the 76, 15 were given between 5 to 7 and maximum were given more than 7, which is more accurate. And out of the 82 that we found lens changes, 40 were given more than 7. This is a pictorial depiction of the same. Now, how do we judge the quality of vision? We see that the modular transfer function was directly correlated to the DLI. And the Stearns ratio also, which is contrast sensitivity, was again directly related. The internal higher order aberrations were inversely related to the DLI. The cataract grading also on the iTrace gave a higher grading for people who had dysfunctional lens index less than 5. Again, we found an incidental finding also in our paper, which was that till now we take maximum density for the Pentacam as the it is the maximum density that we take as the parameter, but what we found in our paper was that the average density correlated best with the DLI. So can DLI be the new gold standard for refractive lens exchange? According to the QOL index also, out of the 158 eyes, 14 eyes which had DLI of less than 5, we went ahead and operated 10 of these eyes based on the DLI itself. And what we found was that 1 month later, the QOL average, there was 40% increase in the happiness index of the patient. So what we know is that presbyopia is the earliest subtle change in the lens before development of cataract. Dysfunctional lens index is an entity where patients experience poor vision quality in spite of clear lens and objective vision recording. Replacing the natural dysfunctional lens with an artificial IOL corrects the visual symptoms of these patients. What our study adds is that iTrace is one of the most important tools in decision making for presbyopia management technique. DLI can be a biomarker for refractive lens exchange. DLI is a reliable quality performance indicator of lens, and it tells us if a clear lens looking lens acts like a cataract. Translational potential, we are also currently working on an index linking DLI and phaco settings for objective application, and visual quantification of lens changes can be, have tremendous potential in patient counseling for cataract surgery. Thank you.
Thank you.
Can you advise surgery depending based on this?
So sir, we did the surgery. Once we did the surgery on based on this, sir, we found that when we gave the QOL form after 1 month again, so patient actually reported that their glare halos had actually come down, even in clear lenses. What the strong point here is that we can visually tell the patient that there is an objective from 0 to 10, and there is a grading less than 5, 5 to 7, 7 to 10. So subjectively telling the patient that you have a cataract, and visually telling him, see, this is the scale, and this is what your dysfunctional lens index is, and that is why we can operate upon you.
This will increase the clear lens.
Yes. And also,
that
is and sir, also that we know that demographically right now, 65% of India is less than 35 years of age. So in the coming decade, it has huge potential because all of this population is going to be moving into that zone of where we have this study.
The earlier you operate, then you need to give, you know, think in time of terms of the near, you know, vision correction also.
Yes.
At an earlier age.
At an earlier age, sir.
Isn't it?
So yes.
Whatever
correct.
Is they having the accommodation, they will be, spending on for 5 years. You're cutting that 5 years, and you need to compensate in the lens.
So as we said, sir, the average age was 57 in these patients. I mean, yeah.
That's what I was his average age was 57 years. And increasing quality of life happiness index by 40%.
Yes, sir.
If we imply this to the youngsters, younger generation.
They require more.
No, they require more, but an accurate 6-6 and 6 trifocal or multifocal.
Yes.
That is a big question.
That's
so
it.
Giving a remark, you know, that we can do clear lens extraction in early press bio.
So this is only
so
for...
This can be implied only for an age group which are vulnerable to cataract.
Correct, sir.
And also presbyopic age.
Presbyopic, 38 is also presbyopic, pre-presbyopia, 40, 42. So this shouldn't say it's going for clear lens extraction.
So sir, basically we are going for patients in which there are frequent changes of glasses. Even with frequent changes of glasses, they're getting 6-6. But because of frequent changes of glasses, they are unhappy. They don't want.
Any flip side of this? You know, anything you picked up by doing this early surgery and, you know,
no, sir. Those patients, they're still in follow-up with us right now. At this present moment, we gave the QOL form at 1 month. We're again going to be giving them QOL forms at 6 months.
What is the maximum followability of these patients?
Sir, right now we have 4.5 months of these patients post-operatively. Post-operatively.
Okay.
How did you convince them for surgery in the first place?
So because of this index only, we showed the index to these patients that now we have something that we can show on a machine. Objectively.
Objectively,
if their DLI, we were not operating anyone whose DLI was more than 5. Only if DLI was less than 5, we were operating, sir.
To convince them only on the basis of DLI?
No, sir. They are self-convinced because, sir, they don't want changes of glasses. They're getting severe, continuous changing of glasses, so they want to get rid of it.
The area of practice of him is totally different than...
No, sir.
That's because more IT people are there. Their knowledge and understanding will be much different than in different parts of the country where the age group is totally different.
Very true.
But good study, Ron. Thank you.
Thank you.